Hi, I'm Greg Paulson at Xometry, and today I want to talk to you about why it's so important to consider support structures when designing for your 3D printed metal parts. So what's support structure? Well, it's a lattice structure that actually holds overhanging features on your 3D printed design, as well as it holds your actual design to a build plate to prevent any warping or distortion during the print. In plastics, it's easy to remove because sometimes it's water soluble or it's a material that can just be plied off. Some of our plastics, like selective laser sintered nylon, actually don't even require support structures because the part is actually suspended within a powder bed as it grows. With 3D printed metal, however, I'm building support structures in the actual build material, so aluminums or steels. And this material can be very, very hard to remove from the part. So I want to talk to you about how to mitigate that in your design, if at all possible, and some key considerations to give you a better and more repeatable 3D printed metal part. So how will it grow? Let's find out. So I have a few parts in front of me, going from very, very simple unsupported features, or what we call naturally grown features, up to much more complex pieces, and I'll go over them right now. These three parts are actually naturally grown, which means that the only thing that's fused to the build plate is the very base of that part. It's typically either removed via manual manipulation or wire EDM. In this case, you can see that this part has natural growing features of a 45 degree angle or things that grow directly vertical from the build plate. This piece here, although it does have some internal threads, it has a much more simple base to it with a little bit more complex top feature. And of course, our Xometry X here, very nice, flat, clean base, and you can see that this has actually been machined off, and then you have your complex natural features growing without any extra support structure. With this challenge piece here, you can see that we have geared teeth on both sides. Because of this, I actually had to have one face that was basically sacrificed by support structures, and the other face was growing naturally. The naturally grown face looks much, much smoother, while the other side had steel support structures, which we removed, but it left kind of a grid-like pattern. On this piece, we actually left the support structures on to show you what it actually looks like before it gets post-processed and shipped out to you. You can see that these are generated scaffoldings that are actually used to hold your piece, which is often grown at a 45 degree angle in order to compensate for some of your features. What's unique about this is on the inside, I have some of these grooved lips. These lips are actually supported all the way through with about 3 inches of support that starts at the base here from the build plate and builds to the top just to hold those features on. You can do some quick design changes to help mitigate this, changing, for example, all your pockets and putting them on one side, so I could actually just grow this part from the bottom to the top versus growing at an angle. The thing to consider, though, when you really, really want to make a part that's unsupported is how many parts you're making and how repeatable do you want this to be. If this is a part that you want to have the same part over and over again, I highly recommend taking the extra time to create as many self-supporting structures as possible, and especially making sure that your critical features do not require support, or at least that you can live with a supported face that may be slightly rougher. At Xometry, we have live engineering support to help review your files and make sure that you're on the right track with your design. You can also use our SOLIDWORKS add-in, as well as our online quoting system for instant design feedback. And we also have many reference guides, including our DMLS design guide, right on the website. Well, great. I hope you learned a little bit more about how DMLS parts are built and how to consider support structures when you're designing your next project. Thank you very much.